In this video, I want to briefly introduce the idea of transgenic organisms, also called genetically modified organisms. These are organisms whose genomes have been permanently altered through genetic engineering. Note that this is different from adding a plasmid to the organism because the plasmid is not part of the genome and can be lost from the organism. Studying a purified protein can take us only so far in understanding its function. Ultimately, we want to understand its role in the living organism, where its expression is subject to regulation, and where it interacts with all the other molecules present. Manipulating a gene in an organism's genome is a good way to gain information about what the gene product is doing in that organism. We can make three main types of changes to a gene. We can replace a normal gene with a modified version, we can eliminate or knock out the gene, or we can add a gene, which generally results in higher expression than usual. Observing the changes that occur in any of these situations can give valuable information about the role of the gene. A powerful method to edit genomes is the CRISPR-Cas9 system. CRISPR stands for Clustered, Regularly Interspaced, Short Palindromic Repeats. Cas9 is an endonuclease that creates double-strand breaks in DNA. Unlike restriction endonucleases, each of which cuts DNA at a defined, unchanging target sequence, Cas9 is directed to cut specific sites on DNA by a guide RNA that binds to the enzyme. Without the guide RNA, Cas9 will not cut DNA. This means that researchers can direct Cas9 to cut DNA at specific sites by providing an appropriate guide RNA. The guide RNA is about 30 nucleotides long and contains about 20 nucleotides that specify the site at which Cas9 will cut the DNA. Because the sequence used for recognition of the cut site is so long, a complementary sequence will occur quite rarely just by chance. For example, a given 20 nucleotide sequence is expected to occur about once in every 4 to the power of 20 bases in a random sequence of DNA, or about once in a trillion bases. The largest genome known has about 149 billion bases in it, which is about 50 times larger than the human genome. So it's quite unlikely that a targeted 20 nucleotide sequence will be present more than once in a typical organism's genome. Thus, we should be able to target sites for gene editing very specifically using the CRISPR-Cas9 system. Now, in practice, the specificity of CRISPR is reduced from what is theoretically possible because the system is tolerant of a few mismatches between the guide RNA and the target site. After Cas9 has made a double-strand break in the genome, the organism's double-strand break repair machinery will try to fix the break. If it does so by non-homologous end joining, then it is likely that bases will be lost at the repair site. If the site is toward the beginning of a gene, there's a good chance that the gene will be inactivated or knocked out. Otherwise, the organism might repair the double-strand break by homologous end joining. If the researcher has provided some replacement DNA, there's a chance the organism will copy that during its repair of the double-strand break, in which case an altered version of the gene of interest could be created. Alternatively, an entire gene could be added at the site of repair. CRISPR-Cas9 has made it much easier to create transgenic organisms, enabling us to study gene function in the whole organism. But to be useful, we need to have a lot of information about the genome of the organism under study. In the next series of videos, I'll go over some basics of sequencing and annotating genomes.